The next day, we've had patients come in here. One guy in particular, he ate meat. 3.5 hours later, he starts itching. He sits down on the floor, realizes he's in trouble, and rings 911. The two ambulance attendants weighed less. They, each of them, weighed less than half what he weighed, and they couldn't carry him. But he lived on a trail in a mobile home, and they had to get him to stand up. And he stood up and walked to the ambulance, but he was fully conscious, but went blind. And he actually lost sight altogether.
Why?
Blood pressure was recorded at one point at 40 over nothing.
Oh, that's why he went blind. He lost the circulation.
He can lose circulation of his cortex, but remain conscious. Most people will go unconscious before they realize that they're blind. So it's very unusual. His tryptase was 90.
Oh, wow.
Which is the highest value I've ever seen in a person who survived.
Huh.
But remember, our patient that we published had a tryptase reported as 2,000.
Wow. And the listeners can't appreciate this. These are super high levels.
These are astonishingly high levels. And the only good place they've been published before was a paper by John Junginger from the Mayo in the early years of the test. And he said that patients who got venom anaphylaxis could have levels like 2,000 or 1,000. But if you ask most people in our practice, Mike Nelson, you know, is the head of our division now. And I asked him, what's the highest level? He's never seen a value over 100. It's very unusual. But
would you say, though, do like 95% of these patients have GI symptoms? I mean, can it present where they do not have gastrointestinal symptoms?
No, absolutely. Absolutely not. You can have hives only. I get hives only. I've been covered in hives. The first time I had a bad reaction,
You've had alpha gal yourself?
Of course. I'm a real scientist.
Oh, you made sure to give it to yourself.
I did not give it to myself, but I went for a walk and got 200 seed ticks on me, the baby larvae, the larvae of the Lone Star tick.
Right.
And I actually sent them to a real acarologist at Cal Berkeley, and he said